an absolutely savage, heinous debacle here inside the Bitcoin chart is what we're seeing right now, potentially a topping out formation signaling the end of the micro bull trend. Let's dive in and analyze. What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Crypto Kirby here, your cryptocurrency expert, back with another edition of the Daily Live Stream. What is going on, my friends? Today I'd like to discuss Bitcoin and the action we're seeing inside the chart right now. Bitcoin has been on a savage, parabolic rip to the upside over the course of the past 2 months. And right now, my friends, it does appear that there is some weakness showing through right now. Is this potentially the top, or is this just going to wind up being a healthy pullback, a healthy correction before the next leg to the upside? So as a full-time trader, I'd like to discuss with you my strategy, my game plan, and how I plan to crush this market right now in the immediate term. So without any further ado, you guys already know the deal. If you like these daily crypto videos and nightly live streams, smack that thumbs up button, click the subscribe, tick the little bell, and let's get this crypto. Moon the likes, ladies and gentlemen. Moon them up. All right, so we'll begin with our Bitcoin technical analysis. And of course, before we begin, this is not investment advice. This is not trading advice. These are only my own opinions, ideas, and speculative hypotheses on the market. Always do your own research and your own due diligence before investing or trading, as this market is extremely high risk, and I am not your financial advisor. I will never tell you what to do with your trades or investments. That being said, let's begin right here on the one-day time frame for Bitcoin. So, my friends, today we've seen an absolutely catastrophic decline, really just another fakeout, and I was pointing this out on yesterday's stream. If you are subscribed here, you would know that I was preparing you mentally for the potential dump that could occur after a fakeout of the Golden Cross. Now, of course, the Golden Cross, the 50-day moving average crossing the 200-day moving average, that is a classic bullish technical indicator. But we've seen time and time again in this savage cryptocurrency market that these very blatant indicators can actually cause a fake out. We saw it here with the death cross, leading to a short squeeze of roughly 40% to the upside in less than 24 hours time. And right now, my friends, we've seen it here once again with Bitcoin dropping nearly 10% today after seeing this golden cross on yesterday's daily candle body close. Let's get this crypto. Savage, heinous, and borderline ludicrous if you do in fact ask me. So my friends, now we have to examine the facts here. Well, what's happened historically? Of course, past performance does not indicate future results, but what can we take from the past that could possibly apply to the present? And what does this look like here in terms of the micro trend? Is this still looking healthy or not? Well, let's look here. We saw on our first rally up, we did exactly what this trend has grown to do over time. And that, my friends, is take out the prior ceiling of resistance, back test it, create a new floor, then rip through the ceiling once again, right? That has been the characteristic of this trend. And right now, for the first time, we're seeing a real struggle occur here, where if you notice on the last two times this has happened, we saw 3 days in a row here of straight upside action to take out the ceiling. Then over here, well more than 3 days of upside action to take out the ceiling. And now, my friends, we did finally get that bounce off of the tentative new floor following the fractal that we have seen playing out here over and over again. But right now, for the first time, we saw that we had this daily green candle come in, looking like it could be a potential continuation of this. But now, my friends, we've seen this massive bearish candle here. This is not, what you'd like to see. When you see a bullish engulfing one-day candle like this, coming off of a potential floor support zone, you would have liked to see this continue with further upside action to take out the prior high, just as we've seen happen the past two times. Right now, this does appear to be different. We haven't seen a bearish candle come in on the one day like this the last several times that this has been playing out. So does the trend right now have a different characteristic? to the pattern that we've seen playing out now for 2 months? I would say so. And what's quite concerning for me here is that when we go into the 4 hour time frame now, and we look at this on a even more micro perspective, what we can see here, my friends, is very clearly that Bitcoin has been rejected back at the old level of resistance here, right? That's then turned into a little support and then failed. And upon retest, where did we get that failure, ladies and gentlemen? Ding, ding, ding. Chicken wings for dinner. Tofu if you're vegan. Right at the old support becomes new resistance, and then a plunge deep down into the crypto abyss. So right now, there are some key levels here to watch, and I need you to look at them very closely. So you could see that Bitcoin did have a wick below this green box for me, right? And the green box, simply put, ladies and gentlemen, is this old resistance, which then we saw act as the new temporary floor before rising up, and then obviously we failed at this region. But for the time being, Bitcoin is still clinging on by a thread to this old resistance turned into new support area. We wicked below, but apparently there were a ton of buy orders in this area that wicked the price back up. What's concerning for me now is that this looks like a pretty clear-cut head and shoulders type of pattern here. Even if it's not perfect, these types of patterns essentially show potential weakness in the market, where you are starting to see the bears take control, putting in lower highs with a flat line along the bottom, which if potentially broken and closed below can lead to further downside action. We did get a fake out here. That's why it's important when trading patterns to await for proper confirmations. And even when the confirmations do actually come in, they still can just reverse. Nothing is perfect. There are no guarantees or certainties in trading. Even the best pattern or the best trade setup can still fail and lead to a capital loss. But right now we did see a fake out of the potential head and shoulders pattern. And right now I am still awaiting further confirmations. You guys would know, if you are subscribed here, if you are in my VIP, you guys would know that I've not been in a position up in this range. And the reason for that is that the risk profile here, in my opinion, was certainly higher than average. So I was not in a long, I was not in a short. And you know, these types of movements here, ladies and gentlemen, these BARTs, up, then down, and again, down, then up, then sideways, then down again. This is an environment that is very, very difficult for trading, right? Because the chances are your stop loss or your liquidation point is going to get hit either long or short, both directions, unless it's an incredibly quick trade in, out, and that is very difficult to accomplish, especially in conditions that are chopping in this heinous type of environment. So for me right now, I have not been in a position, and I've been awaiting more information, and right now the trend is beginning to show me, to show the Don Carbonaccio, that we may be at the beginning stages here of a potential new channel being created, right? You guys see that this channel to the upside here, I'm just going to draw these quickly, you know, not perfect lines. We've been in an upward sloping channel, bouncing off the top upward sloping resistance, trending back down towards the bottom upward sloping support. And now, my friends, it's quite possible here, in my opinion, that we are seeing this change now into a topping out formation up here, then leading into a potential new descending channel, something like this, for a correction, potentially back down into a healthy territory. Now, what do I mean by a healthy territory? For me here, my friends, a healthy territory is going to be anywhere above this white box, right? Now, you guys can clearly see this here, that this has been an area that Bitcoin has respected greatly over the past year, right? And for me, we also see this confirmation here, or rather, excuse me, the confluence of the 0.5 and the 0.618 Fibonacci retracements of this move in particular. So for me here, what I am looking for right now is that if we do pull back down into this region, that Bitcoin still could be clinging on in a hopeful zone, that the bulls don't have to have lost all control of the trend here. It's quite possible that this could be an area that the bulls look to defend and continue the uptrend. One moment, my friends, just one moment. And so if the Bulls do in fact defend this region down here, the macro trend still could be potentially upheld, in my opinion. It could wind up forming something like a long-term W type of pattern, right? If we are to get something like this. But if this region is broken, I mean, things really don't look like they've changed at all. Rather, it would just be a savage double top fake out, leading to another bearish top being built, and a continuation of the bear market, right? So if you guys are subscribed here, you would know on yesterday's stream, I was pointing out how there seems to be more bullish confluence than not. And that still is true for the most part, in my opinion. I was showing you guys the daily here with the 50 and the 200 day moving averages crossing, right? Definitely a bullish sign per classical technical analysis theory. We are still tentatively holding above this green box of tentative support, right? Which also coincides with these bottoms here, all the resistance here and here. As long as Bitcoin is still up in this range, I don't want to say that the bullish trend has to be over. But on a micro level, zoomed in here on the 4 hour, there are some concerning signs here for me, right? I just want you to be well aware that this could be the point in the trend where it's changing, right? And if we now look at our RSIs here, we could see that on the 4 hour, right at the top, we went into overbought conditions, corrected. It seems natural to me there, right? If we go to our 1 day right now as well, overbought conditions before a correction seems very normal to me there as well. And the fact of the matter is here is that, you know, at some point, this trend was due for a correction, in my opinion. And if we want to take the move here, let's look at some different Fibonacci's for now, okay? We're going to actually remove this one here, as we've already discussed the 0.5 and the 0.618 down in the mid 8,000 to low 8,000 vicinity being a potential macro target for me. Let's discuss some micro targets here. We'll pull up the fibs of the very, very micro swings. Let's take a look at this one here. Right now, we would be looking for a potential hold around the 0.618 golden, which is where we are at now, around 9,620. Also coinciding here with our green box of potential historic price action support, right? That is a confluence. That is what you would like to see. So there it is on the very, very micro swing. If we pull it up from this one down here, let me actually make sure that this is perfect. Okay. Let's get it right from this wick down to this wick up. And if we are looking for something a little bit deeper in the retracement, my friends, around 9,100 is the next golden Fibonacci retracement there, which, you know, coincidentally coincides there right around the golden cross on the moving averages. So for me, that is also another little area I could be looking for potential bullish support to come in. Of course, that's just speculative. It doesn't need to act as support. It could fall right through. We may never even get there, right? But the other looming factor here, my friends, is the Bitcoin CME futures chart. And this is where it gets very concerning for me here, is because we do still have this gap here around 8,540. Now, many want to disregard these gaps. And I mean, if you want to disregard it, you can. The problem for me is that I don't like to omit data here. And the fact is that we've seen these gaps just fill over and over and over and over again. With a very, very high rate of accuracy throughout Bitcoin's history. I mean, it's not a 100%, but a very, very large percentage of the time we've seen these gaps fill. There is also a gap overhead there at 11,795. But right now, if this trend is beginning to start to roll over, right, and we are seeing that this is changing from more so of an upward sloping ascending channel to a potentially downward sloping descending channel, my friends, I don't want to lose sight that there is a gap at 8,540 that could potentially fill. Let's get this crypto. A very exciting market environment right here, right now. If you are not, seeing the action here, I mean, I think that we're at a point where this trend is going to get a definitive answer. I think we are going to say, hey, is this actually the bull run of 2020 leading into the halving? And is this actually going to be a moonshot with potential new all-time high potential targets, right? Or is this actually just going to wind up being a failed reaction rally, similar to what we've seen all along throughout this downtrend, right? Just blow off top, failed rally, failed rally, failed rally. Is this going to be another failed rally? I mean, only time will tell. But I mean, to me, it seems like we could be at a macro double top here. It's very interesting, to say the least, right? And I don't want you guys to think that right now I'm permanently bullish or permanently bearish. That is completely not the case here right now. For me, I'm actually very, very neutral here. I think that this has been a very dangerous high-risk area to trade. That's why I personally have not been in a new position right there. But I am looking for new positions right now. Whether that's going to be to the upside with a long or to the downside with a short, I'm waiting for further confirmations in the trend here for me to give me a better high reward, low risk trade setup as I look to tentatively crush the market to the best of my ability. And if you do want to see all of my future trade setup ideas, strategy ideas, etc., I will be posting all of that exclusively for you in VIP. Let's get this crypto. I will see you in VIP right now after this video. Let's get this crypto. So my friends, right now, we got this fake out. I pointed it out on yesterday's video. I said that watch out for that golden cross. They know, ladies and gentlemen, by they, I mean the big entities in this market, the large, large entities know that you and other retail traders are looking at this and saying, it's bullish, gotta go to the moon. And then they dump it in your face, right? Because so many, think about this. What happened here, right? What happened here that allowed a 10% move to the downside to occur so quickly? People saw this golden cross and they place longs. So then what do the whales do? Boom, squeeze it. And they squeeze it to the downside. They take advantage of that newfound liquidity. They squeeze it, and now they're going to go about their business. So we need to see what's going to happen at these very critical levels. I know that I'm looking to trade this to the best of my ability for potentially life-changing trading opportunity. I will keep you all updated in VIP with all of my trade setup ideas in real time. If you're not already in my VIP, ladies and gentlemen, today is truly the day. It's time to transform yourself from average Joe into savage Joe. Let's get this crypto. I'll see you in VIP right now after this video. Let's get this crypto. And my friends, if you could one last time, moon the likes, moon them up, smash those thumbs, click the subscribe button, and tick the little bell. And let's get this crypto. It's been my absolute pleasure. Really would appreciate a thumbs up and a comment here today, guys. Let's get this crypto. And until next time, my friends, I'll see you all in VIP right now after this video. Let's get this crypto. Be safe, be happy, be healthy. It's your boy, Crypto Kirby. Peace and love, my friends. Curbs.